Dumela mara gesho na kalina ke na tshofa tshomali. Otherwise known as Chogeli, and I'm back again on your screen. I'm back again on the YouTube with another sit down video. Like, listen. I know that with this channel, what I want to do is I want to do story times. I also want to do authentic African stories, where I talk about, you know, authentic African stories. Like they're very superstitious, they're very mysterious, but they're very African as well. You know, I want to go in that direction. Like, I'm looking at this, I'm like, it is what it is. Yeah, well, but I need to settle back in into doing sit down videos again. So before Kubela back to Tabatago Kalosa, like, what has been going on in my life, what has been happening, what's happening out there in the world, I gotta deal with the inner self. And you know what, like, I just, like, I wanna be, sorry, my lips are dry. I really wanna be as authentic as I possibly can on here, on YouTube. I'm gonna share, like, I'm trying to make myself somebody that I literally am not. So the best thing to do is to come on here and be really, really authentic and be true and honest with myself and just be as honest as I possibly can. Right. So what are we talking about today? Okay, so today I really just want to talk about isolation. Everything and anything isolation. Like, you know how when you're scrolling through social media, like when I'm scrolling through social media, basically I come across these talks on my For You page, my longhore, like motivation about, like, yeah, if you really wanna, like, get into, if you wanna be into in this new chapter of your life, you have to isolate, you have to be by yourself so that you can know who you are and whatnot. And like, I just want to, like, dive into that and also just talk about my experiences with that, because sometimes I'm learning, believe it or not. Because sometimes I watch back on these videos and I'm like, okay, facts. More and I like, he's hairy, eh? Barikin kaspidi. Yeah, go pilo homuli nak. That's what I wanted to say. Okay, so isolation. For me, I'm not an introvert. I'm an extrovert. I like being out and about. I like being around people. Sometimes I just want to be around people without even having to talk to people. I don't know if that makes sense, but like, it happens. It's something that happens. It's something that I like doing. So isolation, like being by yourself. Yeah. That stuff is hard, okay? That is the hardest thing you can ever do, because when you're isolating, like, you really have to, face your inner demons. You have to do some self-introspection, because I don't know moka chavela go, I don't know mutuka tlhamuru blelena. Kuri, like, isolation go nodula with yourself and your thoughts and face your demons, like, head on. Do you know how difficult that is? Obviously, at the end of the day, you always come out stronger. I always come out stronger. But having to go through that process, man, like, yo, and I can talk about isolating is that sometimes you're isolating and you, like, I tend to overthink. I tend to take it to the extreme. Like, yes, you have to be by yourself. Yes, you have to be within your thoughts. Yes, you have to look in. But so now can I tendency but I wanna get into this one of sitting within your thoughts and just facing your demons head on. Cause I had to ask myself for like why don't I like being by myself? Like a group work, and some things they don't require group work, some things they don't require or Ruby Chamahot or Arieng, some things they don't require you to call your boyfriend or Bebe Arie. Some things you just have to do them by yourself. Some things you have to do them by yourself. And for now, like, this is a lesson that I had to learn the hard way because it took God, I don't know, I believe in God, I believe in the universe, I believe in my ancestors. So I think it took all three things for me. Gori, kebe kebe accept or okay, sharp, like, yeah. Okay, I need to be by myself. Because what would happen is that, like, God would remove people from my life. Like, I gotta be like, people would just, you know, fall off. Then now, like, I'd be around certain people and I just feel like I don't belong in those spaces anymore. Like, I just feel so out of place, which is unlike me because I'm like very adaptable. Like, I can like be in different spaces. Like, it don't matter if we're in Santon or we're in Kasi or what. Like, it don't matter, I'll fit in. Like, I fit in everywhere. But like, I stick out like a sore thumb. I don't even feel like I belong. I cannot interact with these people. Like, I just cannot have conversations with them. I feel so out of place. I just wanna go home. Okay. Cut the camera. Girl, you need to, like, just get away from people. Just go be by yourself. You know? But it wasn't easy because like coming to that realization now you don't fit in the spaces anymore, it's like, damn. It's not always like, it's like, damn, vele, like, I can't be here anymore. Because sometimes, like, okra, like, for now, like, okra, little spaces or places where I get to like de-stress, where I don't have to think about the future, where I don't have to think about the past, where I'm just living in the moment and I'm genuinely just having a good time. Mara, nako ya ka hore ke chile diplekentu ke chile lothuwe, it had come to an end and I could feel it within, or it's like, I don't belong in these spaces anymore. And it wasn't nice, you know, because like sometimes you can like, and sometimes one thing I realized, actually what I'm trying to do is run away from my thoughts. And I want to go back into those spaces. But everything in me just like says no. And that's how I know okay, sharp, more I need to isolate. Sometimes another indication like I need to isolate is when like I can't, like I'm sort of having arguments with people. Like, you know, like unnecessarily so, and I'm just like, okay, like, why am I having a falling out with this person? Like, it doesn't make any sense. What are we even fighting about? And it's because around people when my spirit, when my intuition is clearly saying like, Chiro, you need to sit down with yourself and you need to look and check what didn't hang. Kai. Didn't hang, baby girl. Didn't hang. Why open local focus? Open local focus. What's a kid duty? Kill you, man. Wanna come ring? Like, and just like battling my demons, you know? Mostly like things that I'll be thinking about when I'm alone, like about the future and just like my life, like where, like, you know, some days I wake up and I'm like, I know for sure where what I'm doing with my life and where I'm going. Some days I wake up and I have no idea what I'm doing, where the direction of my life is going, and I'll start tripping. A legit start tripping. And sometimes overthink. But sometimes you have to sit with those thoughts and you have to face them. You need to face them. You need to check reality. And sometimes go isolate, which is something that I also learned. Sometimes like go isolate, like you are able to see who's for you and who's not for you, because I gotta, you withdraw yourself a bit from society and whoever and everybody, just like a little bit, like not for too long though, because we're like depression. So but you just have to sometimes like go back, have some self introspection, like sometimes gotta get a booty shower, okay, like how, like why do I attract the type of people that I attract in my life, type of men that I attract? What is it about me that's giving this vibe? You know, like I'm getting back from these men, because sometimes, like sometimes it's not them, sometimes it's you. Sometimes Gwena, sometimes you have some issues that you need to deal with, you know. And I think with me, I had to, like, I realized, like, flip, there's actually some traumas that I've been through in my previous relationship, that I've actually never dealt with. And sometimes, like, I carry that trauma with me into a new thing, like, into a new relationship, which begs the question, like, are you even ready for a relationship? Should you even be dating, or should you be dealing with the traumas? And I'll be like, flip. Cause I also isolate and I come home and do some self introspection. I noticed, okay, like there's a pattern with me of self sabotage. Sometimes, like I'd get into a thing with a guy and the minute it starts feeling like it's good, like I panic, which is crazy, right? Like, why are you panicking, baby girl? Isn't this what you wanted? I panic and Katomoko put her things like, oh no, this is too good to be true. Why? Because I'm used to the past traumas I've experienced in my relationship, you know. This is too good to be true. Like, what if this person is just love bombing you, you know? Why is this person too nice? Like, start getting paranoid. And I had to like sit down with myself and then like I got to realize that, oh, like the reason why I self-sabotage sometimes, the reason why I'm uncomfortable with some of my thoughts, I mean with like a good thing sometimes, it's because I'm so comfortable with the chaos that when there's peace I get worried, I get bored. I was like, fuck. Sure, fuck. This is deep. I mean, I think one day when I'm ready, when I'm within my capacity, I will speak about the trauma that I've experienced in my relationship, in my relationships, previous relationships. I will speak on that. But for now, it's like it didn't run. And sometimes, ne, another thing, you don't work, you know, it's a bit fucked up. Because I meet someone, ne, and this person like is genuinely love bombing. This person is genuinely love bombing, ne, and then I can see, I can tell that this is love bombing. I can feel that this is love bombing, but I also like convince myself, okay, maybe it's not love bombing. Maybe it's me self-sabotaging again. Maybe it's me coming in with my traumas. And the minute I start doing that, like, so I wanna like, dude, I see, like, I can tell a manipulator from a mile away, and I can tell when someone is manipulating or trying to manipulate. But I would also guess like myself, like, I'm not even lying, like, I'm not even being gaslit by this person. I also guess like myself into saying maybe it's my traumas. But love bombing is real. Okay, I know that I said I'm gonna be talking on isolation, but I'm just speaking on what's in my heart and what's flowing, and if this is what's flowing, then so be it. But love bombing is real, guys. Love bombing. Yo, love bombing is real. Okay, so runale love bombing and then runale honeymoon. So love bombing, like in the beginning of this relationship, this person is, it feels like they're throwing all their love at you. It feels, even the love, like it's just so over, and it's so quick. It's very quick, and it's not organic, because it's not a two-way thing. You're not, so you don't feel like you love that person just yet, maybe because it's too soon, you're still trying to get to know that person, and then all of a sudden motoki like, oh, love her too much, oh, love her too much, man, everything, like jiki, you've met the family, jiki. So everything just happens so fast. This is love bombing, and this person is actually making you get used to it, like a certain type of habit, or right, like a certain type of habit, and they want you to sort of depend on their love somehow. So mutono khotsa lori like is always talking about like loving you, like when I feel okay, this is too much and this is too soon, but you feel a bit guilty for not loving them back. See, that is love bombing. I like with honeymoon, because with a honeymoon phase is not love. Like, honeymoon phase is, you guys are just so infatuated with each other, and the feeling is mutual. So the feeling is mutual. Unlike with love bombing is one-sided, and it's coming from one side, directed at you, like like so much, like, and then re a love bomber atoma feel like the love bombing is not working, they will manipulate you into, well, they will gaslight you into like feeling guilty for not loving them back. Because they will say, listen, I'm doing everything for you. Like, I'm trying my best here. Why can't you just love me? And then, like, you can't love the person because legit, everything. And if you can say, I love you too, once, they got you. It's chai, because then this person would not want a change in the behavior, the change in like pattern, like the consistency is no longer there. So consistency is no longer the same. Now someone might say, okay, maybe ke honeymoon phase e fedile. Honeymoon phase re fedile. Yes, you won't be as infatuated with each other, but the feelings are still there and the feelings are still mutual. Unlike with a love bombing situation, the person will start to make you feel like you owe them for their love. Like, I've loved you for, like, I gave you so much love and you're like, you owe it to me to give it to me back. Type of situation. Why understand that I'm going to. So, let's be careful of that. Because I find myself in a lot, well, not a lot, but a couple of love bombing situations where Lori, Motorola, like, it's like, the love is just so overwhelming at first. And you know what makes it even worse, or what was making it even worse for me, is that, like, everyone around me would tell me, like, oh my god, oh, like, this person just loves you so much. I'm like, shh. And I'd start to think, okay, maybe I'm like a little trauma stuck away. Like, I'm like, oh, reciprocator back. The love that I'm getting from this person. I mean, everyone else can see just how much this person loves me, and they love me so much. They're doing all these things for me, and it's like, am I just ungrateful? You know? And also, then to know, even to Lord, everything is happening fast, quick, in a hurry that I haven't even had time to know, to get to actually know you, to get to actually know a person. Look, mukushisha ro moto ujuan, mukushisha. So it's but you just have to be able to see the signs, man. You just have to be able to see the signs. And like, one thing that I've also noticed that is that most of my past, like, love bombing situations, like, I'd kind of stay in them because I actually did feel like I love the other person back, because, like, I don't fucking know you. Like, I don't know you like that, my nigga. Like, I don't know you like that. Like, I don't know you like that. Like, I really don't know you like that. And I feel guilty for, like, not loving them back. And I feel guilty that they did all these things for me, and I'm just not that interested. And everyone around me just keeps telling me, like, I'm like, yo, like, wow, like, this thing that you guys have is just so awesome. Wow, you guys' relationship is so cute. And no go away, just like, I don't even know this nigga that well, but, and I feel guilty for, like, not maybe, like, giving them the love back. And I'm like, ish, maybe this is my traumas coming back. Maybe this is me. Like, maybe I'll learn to love them. Like, it sounds ridiculous now as I'm saying it, but in the moment, I'll just, like, that's how I'll be feeling. Like, okay, maybe, like, I'll just learn to love them back. After a while, Mutula got more and more interested, then the dynamics will start to shift. The dynamics will change. They start becoming controlling. They start becoming possessive. They want to isolate you. They want your life to revolve around them. At first, when the love bombing started, it seemed like everything I do it for you type of situation. Like, I will support you, baby, no matter what. Now it becomes a thing of, why are you making such decisions? They make you question yourself. Like, they make you question the decisions that you're making. Like, why are you doing this? Which is like a form of control, just to be honest. Why are you doing this? Why are you doing that? Why are you talking to these people? And another red flag that I think you need to look out for with love bombers is they will make it seem like they're the only ones that want what's good for you. Like, where have you been all my life? Where have you been all my life? You suddenly rocked up and now you know what's best for me? You suddenly rocked up and now you know what's best for me? And everybody else is suddenly not good for me? I can hang out with anybody because they're not good for me. And they'll plant seeds in your mind, so you gotta be careful of that. It's also like a way of manipulation and like a way of control. And yeah, it's a way of controlling you. Like, they'll tell you that, oh, like, maybe, like, they'll isolate you from your friends. Like, oh, your friends don't want what's best for you. I'm the only one. You know, like, things like that. And because this person has just been around you, like, so much, and they've been doing so much in such a short space of time, it kind of feels like vele vele, like, they could be right. Remember, you've been spending a lot of time with this person. All of a sudden, like, everybody else just isn't good for you. Except for them. Because, of course, they're good for you. Think about it. Think about it. So those are some of the things that I think about when I'm, like, isolating. And I think about the people that I generally meet. I think about ways to, like, grow myself as a person, like self-development. I do that, and I pray a lot. Like, I pray a lot. Like, some of my prayers would be like, God, I just say, God, what is happening? God, like, my mind is just so confused right now. Please help me see things more clearly. Please lift the fog in my, like, who's for me and who's not for me, who's good for me and who isn't good for me. Like, because I cannot do it on my own right now. And if someone is really not meant for me, I don't care how, it might be painful, mara mudimu, like, just remove them, just remove them. I'll heal. I've healed from so many things. I feel like, yes, I will heal from this as well. So it's crazy. And then you'll just see people distancing themselves, whatever you're supposed to be doing with that particular person who's not meant to be in your life, it will just shakana. And it will just, it don't know, fail like a boyon. Without you having to, like, do a lot. Without you having to lift a finger. It will hurt. It will hurt. Because, I mean, these are people that you care about, that are, like, have become close to you. If they weren't close to you already, it is gonna hurt. But you'll get over it. Just like you got over some of the things that you've been through, Mopilo. So, like, I've learned, like, I'm also still in the process of learning, like, also, like, I'm quick to forgive. I do forgive, but I don't know, is it forgiving if you still resent the person every now and again? And you just think about it and you just, or is it normal? Like, is I think it's normal to feel those feelings, because just because you have forgiven someone and you've healed from something doesn't mean that you won't feel anything about them anymore. I can say, make a sense now. But yeah, man, I feel like because you forgave someone doesn't mean that automatically, like, you won't feel anger when you think about the things that they have done to you. I mean, sometimes similarly, I have to think about like I'm probably the villain in somebody else's story, like in someone else's point of view, like I'm not a good person. In someone else's point of view, I'm a really bad person, and I have to be okay with that, because you know, you can't always be the victim. And one of the things that maybe we don't know about. And in that person's story, like when they think about you, they get anger. They get angry. They feel resentment. And the only thing you can do, I feel, because sometimes I get a lot of hate, it's just to pray for those people and just to say, like, the way, like, it will forgive those who trespass against us as we forgive those, eh? Yeah, but you know what? Okay. Trespass against us as we forgive those who trespass against us. Eh? Forgive. The same way Lerna Sanchez forgive by long river. Yeah, so I'm basically trying to say. But yeah, man, that's what happens in isolation. That's my thought processes. Those are the things I think about. And you know, like I try to live myself. To live my life and just try to be as good, like as good as I can, as kind as I can, but there must be limits to those things, because what I've also come to learn is that people take advantage of other people's kindness. And oh, I also saw something on TikTok that I just have to share it. So this lady was just saying, "Hore, sometimes we carry other people's demons and other people's baggages because you want to help them so much, and it's not your baggage to carry, and that's okay. That's not your baggage to carry. That's not your demon to face. You have your own baggages. You have your own demons. Deal with those. Focus on those. Cause you know, I used to be someone a lot more like okay, well, I still do ksaratago thusha batho, but ba ile ngore ke ke ba thusha. I can't, like, I ke opole na ba thusha in any way, like nothing, whether they're in my life or not. My life has not, it makes no difference, but I do know gore na, like, ke ba thushitse. But at the same time, I'm just like, you know what? Maybe it was God's will. Or mutu tushe mutu gufita na kwe iting. And gufiti shamuwe. It's just too much. But yeah, anyway, like, at the end of the day, my message today is that... So, if you made it to... If you made it up to this point in the video... Isolation is very necessary. Isolation is very needed. But there's limits to isolation, because isolation can lead to anxiety and depression. But do take some time for yourself to self-introspect. Do take time for yourself to see what you need to work on yourself, so that you can be better, so that your life can be better, so that you can attract better. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah, but otherwise, hope you like, subscribe, like, and share this video. Otherwise known as Choco Kelly. And this has been Living Life with Choco Kelly, man. Like, what can I say? If you're enjoying these videos, leave a comment down below. If this resonates with you somehow, leave a comment down below. If you want me to continue doing these type of videos, leave a comment down below. I appreciate it very much. Otherwise, thank you guys for subscribing. It really means a lot to me. My viewers, yo guys, like, yeah, I feel safe. I feel safe with you guys. So thank you so much. Bye.